evening. Good evening, everybody. Good to be in the house one more time. Glad that you're tuning in with us on tonight. We hope that your week is going good for you. We bless the name of the Lord. Amen for what he has done for us thus far on this week. Right where you are, you ought to give God praise on tonight. You ought to lift him up. You ought to glorify him. For our God is great, and he's greatly to be praised. Amen. As you are turning, amen, to 2 Kings chapter 5, amen, we want you to reach out to somebody and ask them to join us on tonight as we finish this series that we've been on for a few weeks. Amen. Turning things around. Amen. We want you to reach out, call somebody, text somebody, let them know to join us right now. Amen. We got a word for you on tonight that we believe will bless you tremendously. And so we want to, amen, have everybody to tune in, as many people as possible on this evening. Click the share button, amen. Do us that favor. Click the share button there on your timeline. Share this, amen, to your friends, amen. Those who take a look at your page, amen. We're looking, amen, to enlarge, to expand. And so you help us out in a great way when you click that share button. Amen. As we come together on tonight, as always, we want to be in prayer for those who stand in need of prayer. Amen. We want to continue to lift up those persons who are still recuperating from surgery. Deacon Sharps, Sister Deborah Logan, Sister Stella Taylor, Brother Robert Dixon. We want to keep lifted up Sister Rosetta Randall. Amen. Sister Rita Weaver, Trustee McDaniel, and those names that are listed there in our bulletin. Amen. We serve, amen, a healing God. We serve a prayer answering God. We believe in the power of prayer. Amen. We believe that, amen, demons tremble when we go into prayer, that the devil has to flee. Amen. When we call on that name that is above every name. And so we go to the throne on tonight believing that God will hear our cry. Father God, we bless you on tonight. We give you the highest praise. God, we lift your name on high. We come on tonight because, God, we're just grateful. Amen, that you still have your hand on us, that you're still watching over us, that you're still, amen, faithful in supplying all of our need. Thank you, God, that we still have a roof over our head. We still, God, have food on the table. Still, God, have good health and strength. And so on tonight, before, God, we ask you for anything, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. We bless you, God, for looking beyond our faults and seeing our needs. God, we ask you for forgiveness on tonight. If we have done anything that has been displeasing in thy sight, we just ask you, God, to have mercy upon us. Forgive us of our iniquities, our transgressions. We ask you, God, to wash us, cleanse us, purge us, God, with hyssop so that we may be whole, in order for us to become, amen, the people, the disciples that you're calling us to be. We come, God, as intercessors on tonight. We come as priests. We come believing, amen, in the power of prayer. We come believing that you'll hear our cry. On tonight, we don't come for ourselves. We come, God, interceding for our brothers and our sisters who are sick, those persons who are afflicted with illness, suffering pain at this particular time. God, we're calling on you to touch their bodies on tonight. We're asking you, God, to have mercy upon them, strengthen them even now. In those places, God, where they are weak, we ask you, God, to just build them up even now in those places where they've been torn down. God, we believe that you're still a miracle worker. And for those who are afflicted with some illness, some disease, we're asking you to work a miracle in their life. We're asking you to be Jehovah Rapha, the Lord God that healeth thee. We know, God, that you have all power in your hand. And so we just ask you to reign and rule over their situation. Show up in a mighty way. Get the glory and the honor. Get the praise out of their situation. We're asking you to grant them the faith that they need in order to make it through whatever they're facing at this particular time. Oh God, we're praising you even now because we know that you are a healer. You've done it for us. We know, God, that you are able to help them to recover, to help them to come back to the house with a testimony, declaring your greatness and your goodness. We ask you even now, God, to bless them with your peace. Yes, that surpasses all understanding. We come against any worry, any stress that they may be going through at this particular time. We cast, God, all of our cares upon you, knowing that you care for us. We ask you, God, just to move in a marvelous way on tonight. We're praying for healing. We're praying for restoration. We come, God, against depression. We come against doubt. We come against fear because we know that you have not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. Grant us a sound mind on tonight. Despite what all is going on in the world, God, help us to focus on you, to trust in you with all of our heart, not to lean unto our own understanding. God, have your way in our lives. We're praying for reconciliation in marriages. We're praying for breakthrough, God, in businesses. We're asking you, God, for increase on tonight, knowing, God, that you sit high, you look low, you have a cattle on a thousand hills. And so we ask you, God, to bless your people on tonight. Open up our ears, open up our hearts so that this seed that you have for us can fall on good ground so that we can witness a harvest, God, from what you have in store for us on tonight. Anoint me afresh to be a blessing unto your people. It's in Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen. Amen. Come on, put those holy hands together on tonight. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. If you know God is a healer, amen, come on and bless him on tonight. If God has healed your body at some point, at some time, come on and give him some praise on this evening. And so we look on tonight to finish the series, Turning Things Around. We've been over a number of points. I hope you got them. Amen. Powerful, amen, points, principles, revelation that God has shared with us. We have three more points for you on this evening. Amen. We're in 2 Kings chapter 5. Amen. We've been dealing with Naaman. Amen. Starting there at verse number 1. We're dealing with Naaman, this brother from Syria. He's commander over the army there in Syria. And Naaman has leprosy, amen, a skin disease, amen, sores, amen, all over his body, amen. He was a valiant soldier, amen, commander in the army, amen. He was a great and honorable man in the eyes of his master, amen. But Naaman had a problem. Amen. Naaman had, amen, this disease called leprosy. And Naaman had this young servant in his house, amen, this young girl from Israel who was captured, amen, when Israel was at war with the opposition, amen. And this young lady is serving Naaman's wife. And she comes up, amen, with this idea, with this suggestion, because she knows that Naaman has leprosy. She knows that he has a disease. And so she says, if he could just get over to Israel, amen, there's a prophet over there named Elisha, amen. She knew about this prophet who God had anointed, God had consecrated to perform miracles. This is Elisha, y'all. Elisha, amen, serve Elijah. And so as a result of being faithful in serving Elijah, amen, God bless Elisha with a double portion of Elijah's spirit, so that Elisha now, amen, is able to perform double the miracles that, amen, his predecessor Elijah was able to perform. And so here it is where this sister gives some advice to Naaman to go to Israel, see the prophet, amen, in order for his leprosy to go away, in order for it to flee from his body. And so we talk, amen, about how Naaman went with these certain expectations, amen. When he met the prophet Elisha, he thought that the prophet, amen, would come out and stand before him, call on the name of his God, wave his hand over, amen, the leprosy, and he thought that he would be healed and restored that way. We talked about the fact that we have to manage our expectations, that Naaman walked away angrily. Yeah, he walked away angry because he thought, amen, his healing was gonna take place a certain way. But Elisha sent a messenger to Naaman and told Naaman to go down to the Jordan River, amen, and wash there, dip there 7 times, and his body would be healed, amen. It would be restored. The leprosy would be gone, amen. Naaman didn't like that, and so he walked away, amen, furious. He was livid because he wanted the healing to take place a certain way. And we talked about how a lot of us, amen, even me, amen, we get upset sometimes because we have, amen, these unrealistic expectations, amen, where we're expecting God to move a certain way, amen, as it relates to our health, as it relates, amen, to the job, as it relates to, amen, our living conditions. We have these expectations in mind, amen, and God may have very well promised, amen, you something, but we have a tendency to want it our way and in our own time. And oftentimes, amen, it doesn't happen that way, and we end up just like Naaman, amen, walking away furious, livid, upset, and angry. Naaman got to the point where he was about to walk away from his blessing. God had healing for him. God had, amen, deliverance for him. Amen. But Naaman was about to miss out on the healing and the deliverance because of his expectations. We have to have, amen, management of our expectations. Amen. So that we don't get upset, so that we don't become, amen, frustrated and angry to the point where we risk missing out on what God has in store for our lives. So we talked about how you have to manage, amen, your expectations. Amen. Then we said, amen, you got to listen to some sound advice. Amen. This advice that he was given, this suggestion, amen, that was made, amen, was made by somebody who was anointed, gifted, amen, and who was called by God. This is the prophet Elisha. He has a track record, amen, of healing, amen, of miracles that he has performed, amen, over the course of his ministry. And sometimes we don't see our situations shift for the better because, amen, we don't adhere to sound advice. Amen. I give Naaman credit. At least he went to somebody who was anointed, who was gifted, who was consecrated by God to, amen, perform the miracle that he needed, to give him, amen, the advice that he needed in order for his situation, amen, to turn around for the better. Amen. Sometimes our situations don't turn around because oftentimes we turn our problem over to the wrong people. Yeah, that's why I say I give Naaman credit. At least he went to somebody who was anointed, gifted, set apart, amen, to perform miracles. Amen. He went to that person, but initially, y'all, amen, he didn't want to adhere to sound advice. We discuss, amen, there in Hosea chapter 4, I believe it's verse number 6, how God says, my people, they are destroyed, they perish for lack of knowledge. They have a lack of knowledge. And we discussed the fact that it wasn't that the knowledge wasn't available. Amen. The knowledge was available. Amen. God sent people in order to give revelation to his people. The knowledge was available. Amen. They just rejected it. Sometimes, amen, we're just like Naaman. We get sound advice. We get revelation from God Sunday after Sunday, Wednesday after Wednesday. You go to the doctor and the doctor give you some sound advice. Amen. You go to the job, amen, and your manager, your supervisor, they give you some sound advice. Amen. You show up to church, amen, and God gives you, amen, a revelatory message, amen, through the preach or through the taught word, amen, but sometimes we reject it. And as a result of rejecting it, guess what? We stay in the same condition. Some people are still in the same condition, amen, because, amen, they either, amen, take their problem to the wrong person, amen, Or they take it to the right person, but they don't take heed to the advice that they were given. And so they're still in debt. They're still unemployed. They're still on drugs. The business hasn't taken off. They're still, amen, depressed. Because, amen, they either go to the wrong person, amen, or they go to the right person, but they don't take heed, amen, to the advice, to the suggestions that are made. And so we want to move on tonight to our last 3 points. I just wanted to share a few things that we've been over already. We want to move to the next point on tonight, so I hope you have your pad, your pencil, your pen, your tablet in order to receive what God has for us on tonight. Here's the next thing on tonight, and that is, if we want to see things turn around, then we must see it through. If we want our situation to turn around, we must see it through. So in verse number 14, amen, it says, so he went down and dipped 7 times in the Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God, and his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child. And he was clean. So Naaman finally decided to take heed of the advice that he was given. He went down to the Jordan. Amen. And he dipped, it says, 7 times. And after he dipped 7 times, it says, amen, his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. He dipped 7 times. Notice the implication is, after the first dip, his flesh wasn't restored. After the second dip, he wasn't clean. He had to dip 7 times, and we know that 7 is the number of completion, but check out what God is trying to share with us on tonight. His situation didn't turn around, amen, quickly. It didn't shift in a hurry. It didn't change overnight. Sometimes we have to display persistence. I told you that during the process, guess what? God is working on us. I need y'all to hear that on tonight. See, we're so focused on the breakthrough and deliverance and the healing that we miss out on the fact, we overlook the fact that God, during the process, is working on our growth. He's working on our development. Oh, my God. And so Elisha tells Naaman to go down to the Jordan and dip 7 times. He didn't tell him, go down there and dip once. Go down there and wash 3 times. No, dip 7 times, because God, amen, is building you. God is shaping you. God is molding you. God is working on areas where he knows you and I are weak. He's working on areas where he knows we are flawed. Yeah, see, this is deep on tonight. Yeah. So when Naaman dips, guess what? He's getting deeper. Yeah. He's getting deeper. Amen. So God, watch this. He may be working on our patience. He may be trying to increase our faith. Oh my God. Yeah. God may be working, amen, on our prayer life. And so it's a process. Yeah, don't just focus on your healing and your deliverance. Guess what? Healing, deliverance, breakthrough is coming. Right? If that's what God has promised you. Uh-huh. Don't focus on that to the point where you overlook the fact that God is working on you. How many people know God is working on you? I know he's working on me. Yeah. Yeah. He's working on the response, amen, that we give when we encounter certain situations. Yeah, he's working on our complaining, our murmuring. He's working on the words that come out of our mouths. Is this helping anybody on tonight? So that Naaman is told to dip seven times. Yeah. And so Naaman has to exhibit persistence. Yeah. He dips one time, but he recognizes he's not healed yet. His flesh hasn't been restored. He's not clean. He's not whole. Amen. But watch this. Naaman doesn't give up. He dips another time. He's still not clean. He's still not restored. Yeah, but he doesn't walk away. No, notice when Naaman didn't have his way, initially he walked away. When he didn't get the results that he desired, he walked away furious, angry, and upset. But watch this. When he dips the first time, the second times, and he recognizes that he's not clean, that he's not whole, that he's not healed, look at it. He doesn't get out of the Jordan and walk away. No, he stays there in the Jordan and dips another time. Oh, man, this is powerful on tonight. See, God is working on your resilience. Because some of us, when we don't get the results that we desire, amen, we throw in the towel. We give up. We cave in. And so God is working on our level of perseverance. Guess what God is doing with us? He's making us stronger. The Bible says, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding. That means you got to see it through. It means that you have to endure the process. I know you want to get back to business. You want to get back to normal, how things used to be. Amen. You want to be healed. Amen. So that you can walk and get around like you used to. Amen. You want to be healed so that you can do the things, function like you used to function before, amen, you got sick before, amen, you had the injury before you got afflicted, amen. But God, amen, is working on your resilience.
He's making you stronger. Yeah, I told you, he's working on your level of resilience, persistence. See, because God knows what you're going to face later on. And so God has to put you through a process. Amen. To work on you so that you can see things through. So you don't get weary in well-doing. Oh, my God. I'm trying to help us on tonight. Yeah, yeah. See, some of us, we get weary. I know you may not admit it on tonight. Yeah, but do I have any real folk out there? Amen. When you do what God has called you to do, when you're faithful, but things don't change. Yeah, and there are times when you and I, guess what? We become exhausted. We get drained because we're being faithful, but yet we haven't seen the change that we desire. And for some people, amen, it's been weeks. For some people, it's been months. Then there are others, guess what? It's been years that you've been seeking this change. Amen. You've been seeking this shift in your life. And there are times along the way, amen, where you get discouraged to the point where you feel like giving up. Oh, my God. But you got to keep on pressing. Do I have anybody out there? Amen. Wave at me. You're going to keep on pressing. Yeah, you're going to keep on showing up. Yeah, you're going to see it through. Yeah, yeah, you've come too far. You, watch this, you've dipped too many times for you to quit now. You've been through too much for you to turn around. Oh, my God, somebody ought to write on the screen, keep dipping. Yeah, yeah, keep dipping. If it doesn't shift, keep on dipping, because watch this, the next dip just might be the one where you experience the shift that you've been waiting on. And so Naaman, he goes down and he dips seven times in the Jordan. Yeah, because it's a process that you and I have to go through where God is working, amen, on us. Yeah, making us stronger. Yeah, helping us to persevere through the problem, the process that we have encountered. And so if we want to turn things around, we have to display persistence. How many people know there were times where you felt like giving up, but you kept going anyhow? And eventually, amen, you saw, amen, the turnaround you desire. Come on, wave at me. Somebody ought to testify. Yeah, somebody, amen, ought to be praising God right now, because you were about to quit. The devil had convinced you to give up, but something, amen, spoke to your heart and said, keep pressing. Keep dipping. Man, can you imagine where you would be, amen, if you didn't decide to keep pressing on to see what the end was going to be? You ought to thank God for giving you the strength to endure, amen, what you face, amen, long time ago. Amen. And so you got to see it through. You got to keep dipping. Here's the next thing. Know that God will use your encounter so that he can be exalted. Know that God will use your encounter so he can be exalted. Oh, my God. Look at the text, y'all. Verse number 15. After Naaman's flesh was restored, like that of a little child, and he was clean, it says he returned to the man of God. He and all his servants, all his aides, and came and stood before him. And he said, "Indeed, now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel." Look at it. Naaman comes to Elisha, stands there in front of him, and he says, "Now I know without a shadow of doubt that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel." Look at it. God used Naaman's encounter with leprosy so that he could be exalted. Oh, my God. Naaman came back and said, "Look, I know without a shadow of a doubt that there is no God, amen, in all the earth except in Israel." You have to recognize that Naaman, amen, is from Syria, and they serve, amen, idol gods. I could just imagine, can't you, that Naaman has probably called on those gods in Syria in order for his leprosy to go away, so that he could be healed, but it didn't work. And so now Naaman can come and he says, "After all my experiences, after all of my calling out to idol gods," he says, "now I know, yeah, that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel." Look at how God operates. God will allow certain things to take place, y'all, just so that he could get the praise. Here it is. It's not about us. Sometimes we take things personal. Yeah, we think that it's about us. Why did this happen to me? Why do I have to go through this? Yeah, when is the Lord going to show up? How long I got to deal with this? I want to help somebody on tonight. Know that God has allowed your situation just so he could get some glory. Yeah, God wants to use that encounter, whatever it is, so that his name, amen, can be glorified, so that he can get the honor, so that he could be lifted up. I told you, amen, that watch this, God is working on your testimony, that God allows trials, amen, in order to give us testimonies. So that when we testify, amen, he will be exalted. He will get all the glory. He will get all the honor. He will get all of the praise. How many people out there can testify, amen, that God healed your body, that God got you out of that trouble, that God delivered you, amen, out of that storm, that God showed up and he provided what you needed, that God, amen, did did some amazing things for you. You can testify, and the only reason you can testify and give God praise is because God allowed the trial. Naaman comes back and he stands before Elisha and his servants. And he says, I know for certain now that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Amen. Right on the screen, God is working, amen, on his praise. God is working, amen, on his glory. That's what he's doing with you and I. Amen. He's going to be exalted. He's going to be lifted higher. Amen. Amen. Honor, glory, and praise, amen, are going to come before him. Amen. After God does what he's about to do in your life, you're going to have to give him all the honor. It was nobody but God, Naaman said, that could do this. I've tried other things. I've tried other gods, but only this God was able to take away my leprosy. Yeah, I wanna let you know, amen, to remain faithful. Yeah, because God is using you in order to bring his name more glory. That says a lot about you. You need to listen to this. That says a lot about you, that God trusts you to handle the predicament that you have. Amen. God trusts you to the point where he knows, despite what you're dealing with, amen, you're not going to walk away. That's why he gave it to you. That's why he allowed it to happen, because God said, I know that they are going to be faithful. They are going to be persistent. They are going to be resilient. And as a result of them being persistent and resilient, amen, they'll overcome. They'll endure whatever they're facing right now. And so I will get the glory and the honor when I decide to show up and turn things around for them. Be encouraged, y'all. Things gonna turn around for you. Oh, I feel it in my spirit. Because God's glory is on the line. And if God's glory is on the line, guess what? God will step in due season. He will step in due time. He's a man of his word. He's not a man that he shall lie. His word shall not return unto him void. He's not going to leave his glory out there. So God will come through. How many people know God will come through for you? If God ever came through for you, why don't you give him praise right now? If God stepped in, if he showed up for you, why don't you give him glory right now? Why don't you encourage somebody out there on tonight? Amen. To hang in there, to see it through. Yeah, to persevere. Because if they persevere, God will get the praise. So you got to see it through. Know that God will use your encounter so he can be exalted. Here's the last thing. Recognize that God seeks to use your episode to change your environment. Oh, man, I love this. God gave me this. Amen. I start shouting. New revelation. Oh, fresh rhema word. This is for somebody on tonight. Look at it, y'all. He returned to the man of God. He and all of his aides, his assistants, his servants, and came and stood before him. And he said, indeed, now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Look at it. This is the revelation that God gave to me. Naaman is the commander, amen, of the army there in Syria. Yeah. Naaman has a position of influence. He has a position of power. He's got the king's ear there in Syria. He went to the king and said, look, I need to go to Israel in order, amen, to get my problem rectified, in order for me to get this problem taken care of. He's got power. He's got clout. He's got influence. Amen. He's got the king's ear in Syria. He's commander over, amen, the army there in Syria. Which means that, watch this, Naaman will go back to Syria, amen, and declare, amen, the works of the Lord. Oh, man, this is so good. I need y'all to get this because it's powerful. Look at it. Because this text just ain't about Naaman getting his situation turned around. But this is also about God turning things around in Syria. Oh, get this. Yeah, see Naaman's servants, amen, They've already witnessed what God has done as a result of Naaman going down to the Jordan and dipping seven times. They've already witnessed, amen, his flesh restored, him being made clean. And now they hear it from his mouth, amen, that there is no God, amen, in all the earth except in Israel. So not only is God turning Naaman's situation around, God is using Naaman's episode, his leprosy, in order to change and shift an environment. Oh, that's powerful. Because you know what God is trying to do? God is trying to shift your environment. Yeah, he's using your episode. Yeah, not only does he want to turn your situation around, but he wants to turn your environment around. See, Naaman is going to go back to Syria, and he's going to testify about how the God of Israel, amen, healed him of leprosy, and how there is no God in all the earth except, amen, in Israel. I told you they serve idol gods in Syria. But look at God. Now God is seeking to shift that environment. Yeah, he's seeking to change that entire atmosphere in Syria. This is powerful. You need to get this. That's why I said this ain't just about you. It's about, amen, the environment that God has you positioned in. This is about, amen, the environment, amen, the place, yeah, where God has set you up in. See, God is strategic. Yeah, he wants to use your situation not just to turn it around, but to turn the people who are connected to you around. Listen to that. Yeah, God works. He moves in mysterious ways. Yeah. Look at what God is saying to the church, to believers on tonight. I just want to use your episode. I want to use, amen, your circumstance. I want to use your struggle, amen, not just to turn you around, your situation around, but I'm seeking to turn around, amen, the atmosphere that I have positioned you in. I want to change your household. I want to change your bloodline. God said, I want to change the ministry. I want to shift things on your job. I want to turn things around in your neighborhood. I want to change stuff for the better in your city. I have positioned you strategically. You've got power. You've got influence. You've got clout. You've got the ear of some powerful people, and God said, I want to use your situation, amen, to turn the atmosphere and the environment where I position you around. Oh, somebody ought to be shouting right now. Yeah, somebody ought to be giving God praise right there in your living room, right there in the kitchen, right there in your bedroom, right there outside on the patio. Somebody ought to be blessing God, because God said, I want to move in such a way where I just don't turn you around, where I just don't turn your situation around, but I'll change, amen, amen, the atmosphere, those folk who you are connected to, I want to turn them around. See, God's ways are not our ways. Yeah, that's what it says in Isaiah 55. His ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. Yeah, but as high as the heavens are from the earth, so are, amen, his thoughts from our thoughts and his ways from our ways. God said, I just don't want to turn you around. I don't just want to, amen, turn your situation around. I want to use your situation in order to change your environment. This is bigger than us. Yeah. To somebody out there, amen, God said he wants to, amen, shift things in your bloodline. He's going to use you, your situation. He said, I want to shift things in the ministry. He said, I'm going to use you to do it. Yeah, I want to shift things in your city, right there in your neighborhood. Yeah, and I'm going to use your situation in order to do it. Because when I get through, God says, people will have to declare that was nobody but God. Man, I hope you were blessed by this lesson. I hope you've been blessed by this series. Amen. I know I have. Amen. I know, amen, that my mindset has shifted as a result of revelation that God has shared with us over the course of these weeks that we've been in this series. Amen. Right where you are, just give God glory. Give him praise. Come on and bless him right where you are. If you've been blessed, click that share button and share this, amen, to your timeline so that others, amen, can hear what the Lord has for them. You ought to call up some family member, some friend, some co-worker, and let them know, amen, to view this study. I believe it'll be a blessing to them. I believe it will be a source of encouragement. I believe it will pick them up, amen, once they hear, amen, the revelation that's coming from on high. There may be somebody, amen, out there who is unsaved. Amen. You don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord, as your Savior. Look at what God did. He used the cross. Amen. He used, amen, the cross. Yeah. He allowed his son to be put on the cross. Yeah, it wasn't just about him. It was bigger than him. It was to die, amen, for our sins. That while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He did something that shifted, amen, the atmosphere, that changed the environment. And so if you're out there, you don't know Jesus Christ as Lord, as Savior, amen, we want to take this opportunity, amen, to invite you, amen, to claim him on tonight as Lord, as Savior. If you confess, amen, with your mouth the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that he is the Son of God, that he died for your sins, yeah, you shall be saved. So if you're in need of salvation, you're looking for a turnaround in your life, you need to connect with the Christ. Amen. He's the way, the truth, and the life. He will, amen, get you on course so that you can witness a shift in your life. So reach out to us on tonight. Amen. Go to the inbox there on the page and give us your name. Give us your number. Amen. Say, I want to be saved. And we'll reach out to you. Amen. Real soon. If you're looking for a church home and you believe that this is the place, this is the house, amen, that God is leading you to, wants you to be a part of, amen, you can reach out on tonight. Go to the inbox. Give us your name. Give us your number. And we'll contact you as well. Amen. It's giving time on tonight. Amen. Before we leave, we want to honor God. Amen. We want to give our offering on tonight. Amen. If you've been blessed by this series, amen, I want you, amen, to give on tonight. So, amen, into the ministry. Amen. Let God know that you appreciate, that you are grateful, you're thankful for the lesson, amen, or lessons that he has provided over the course of these weeks that we've been dealing with this series. So go to givelify.com. Amen. The information is right there on the page. Go to givelify.com. Amen. Find Providence Baptist Church, 1331 30th Street, Newport News, Virginia. Amen. You can give online right now. Amen. Using your credit or your debit card. Or you can go to the Cash App and put in the $PBC News Live. Amen. $PBC News Live. We thank you. Amen. For all of those who are, you know, you're obedient all throughout. Amen. Bible study and giving an offering. We want to thank you for, amen, your commitment, your, amen, generosity, amen, and giving to the Lord in order to help out, amen, the ministry so that we can go on to do greater things for the Lord. Amen. We hope that you've been blessed on tonight. Come on, wave at me. Amen. Wave at me. Yeah, shout at me. Write something on the screen. Amen. Don't forget to click the share button. Click that share button and share this page to your timeline. We look forward to seeing you on this Sunday at 10 o'clock. Amen. We're still going to be dealing, amen, with these vessels. Amen. Amen. If you missed it on this past Sunday, amen, you ought to want to be in the house on this coming Sunday. If you were here last Sunday, you ought to show up on this coming Sunday for worship as we deal, amen, with the woman, amen, who was told to go out throughout the neighborhood, get as many vessels as she could to pay off a debt. And so we want you to be here. Bring somebody with you on, amen, this coming Sunday. God, we love you. We praise you. We thank you. We give you all the glory and the honor. God, thank you on tonight for the revelation, for what you have poured out, amen, on tonight. Help us to receive it in our spirit, to know, God, that you're using our situation to work on us. You're making us stronger. Yes, you're increasing our faith. You're working on our patience. Yeah, you're working on our posture. And so continue, God, to shape and mold us into the vessels that you have ordained for us to be. Then thank you, God, that it's not about us, but God, you seek to be glorified, and you seek, God, to shift the atmosphere, the environment that you have positioned us in. Thank you, God, that you're about to turn some things around. Oh, that a shift is coming. Amen. To transform not just our lives, but the lives of people who are connected to us. We bless you. We exalt you. We give you the highest praise. It's in Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. We'll see you on Sunday.